throws will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I'll find out starting in today's game between the Chattanooga Mocs and the St. Mary's Gales.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Gales should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Nick, as they're highly favored on paper, but what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. Number one, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second, get the ball to your big man on the block early. That'll open up the perimeter game, baby. And finally, get your man on your hip after the shot, block out, and get after those boards.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Here's a nice face-up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
And off the mark. Good job defensively. They just don't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Number one gets the ball. Working it around the perimeter. He pump fakes. Down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They had two.
It's a hoop and a foul.
He showed good concentration on that possession, Brad.
The Gales are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. He gets it to go. It in. He fakes the shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. And on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup.
Look at that spacing.
Number 50 is emotionally fired up.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
Trying to feed inside. Harden fakes the shot. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And he missed. In the paint. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He takes the shot off the baseline, off the rim, and no good. They look to get it to the inside. He's got a nice shot fake. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Hickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, this crowd will go silly if they can get some points this trip. And up and sinks the shot. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
All right, thanks, Aaron. The shooting guard gets the pass. Thinks about the shot. And he'll kick it back outside. He bombs from outside. That's an ill-advised shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
On the outside, number 20 takes the pass. There they are on the low block on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Number 50 is feeling great out there right now.
Hey, can you blame him, Red? He's getting it done. Trying to go inside.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Sets a screen for his teammate. And working around the perimeter. He blocks the shot, and the ball goes out of bounds. Shot clock. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Looks at the three. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Man, he used that screen to perfection. He used it to get free, baby, for the good look.
Number one with the ball. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset with the fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
At the half, the Mocs are behind by seven. Dick, we've got a close one here tonight, my friend. Give us your highlight of the night so far.
Watch here. Pounding the ball inside like you see. And this highlight will take a lot out of a team on defense. I expect to see more of the same from both teams in the second half.
Let's get back to the action and see what happens. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. The shooting guard receives the ball. Picked out of the air. Both teams looking to get things going here. Got a guy right up on him.
Up and inside.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from right of the circle. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. Work the perimeter. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Way off target. Oh, screener seeing stars after that screen. The shooting guard takes the feed. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
Sinks the shot. Takes the shot. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Work it inside and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He shoots from left of the circle. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They're going to have to pull him out and let somebody else out there, let him think about it for a while.
Goes up for two. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that to stop before any further damage is done. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. And they're going to count it.
Determination, baby.
That's a great play. What a play. Demonstrating unbelievable skill. Now look at him. He's celebrating with the cheerleaders.
I love the zest of the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders. That's awesome, Brad.
Number 50 going to the line for the first time tonight. Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
Well, it's simple. They came out, executed a game plan, and ended up on top.
He couldn't get it to fall. On the inside for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
At a three. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
He better get rid of it. Fake. He goes with a jump hook. Rims out. Pushes it up. The point guard with the makes the block. Shot clock is dead. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
On the dribble, gives it up. Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. The ball goes out of bounds. Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I'll tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
The Gales came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm